Hello everyone, this is the second part of lecture series which is based on the hydrodynamic lubrication from your design of machine element subject. I, Professor Neha Dixit, going to explain in this part classification of lubricants, advantages, disadvantages and application of various lubricants, factors influencing selection of a lubricants and desirable properties for the bearing materials. Objectives for this lecture is learner will be able to apply the various types of lubricants according to applications and learner will be able to describe desirable properties of bearing. Now, classification of lubricants. Lubricants can be classified as lubricating oil. In lubricating oils, natural oils, mineral oils with additives, and synthetic oils. Again, lubricants can be classified second type, that is the greases. In greases, lime based grease, soda based grease and lithium based grease. Again, third type of lubricant is solid lubricant. So lubricant can be classified as a lubricating oils, greases and solid lubricants, and lubricating oils again classified into natural oils, mineral oils with additives and synthetic oils. Again, greases are classified as lime based grease, soda based grease and lithium based greases. We will see one by one lubricating oils. In that, first type is natural oils. Natural oils includes vegetable oils, animal oils, and these natural oils used as lubricants up to maximum temperature of 120 degrees Celsius. Advantages of these natural oils. Natural oils are non-volatile, more effective under boundary lubrication condition. While limitations of natural oils, they cannot be used as lubricant above 120 degrees Celsius. At low temperature, oil solidifies and becomes fat, and it has poor oxidation and thermal stability. Applications of natural oils. Castor oil is the example of natural oil which is used in racing cars and aero engines. Rapeseed oil, which is added in a mineral oils to increase the viscosity, and lard oil, which is used as a cutting oil. Second type of a lubricating oil is mineral oils. Mineral oils consist of higher hydrocarbons which are obtained in the process of distillation of a crude petroleum. The mineral oils can be used into a maximum temperature of 200 degrees Celsius. SAE grading of mineral oils. The Society of Automotive Engineering has classified lubricating oils according to their viscosities. Each lubricating oil is designated by SAE grade or number, which is indicative of the viscosity. When SAE number is more, it indicates more viscous oil. Oils with suffix W are called winter grade oils and are used at low ambient temperature. Advantages of mineral oils. Mineral oils are chemically inert. They have wide range of viscosities. They have little tendency to oxidize or form corrosive acids. They can be effectively reused after filtration. Disadvantages of mineral oils. They cannot be used above 200 degrees Celsius temperature, and straight mineral oils have low viscosity index. Mineral oils with additives. Additives is the substance added to the straight mineral oils to improve a particular property of that mineral oils. Mineral oil in which additives are added is called as a base oil. Additives must be suitable to the base oil. Synthetic oil is another type of the lubricating oils. Synthetic oils are synthetic organics which includes synthetic hydrocarbons, fatty acids, etc. They can be used at extreme temperatures, pressures and humidity. They can be used up to 400 degrees Celsius. Normally used as additives in a mineral oils. Second type of lubricants are greases. They are thixotropic substances, that is undergo a change in apparent density with a shear stress. So when shear stress changes, then the viscosity of that substance changes, and that substance is known as a thixotropic substances, and greases are having this property. Journal is a stationary, then grease is a rigid and immobile. When journals start rotating, viscosity of a greases reduces to that of the base oil in grease. And what are the journal and shaft and bearing we will see in next lecture series. Types of greases. Calcium soap grease. It consists of a mineral oil in a calcium soap. Sodium soap grease. It consists of a mineral oil in sodium soap. Lithium soap grease. It consists of a mineral oil in lithium soap. Uses of a greases. Applications where continuous supply of lubricant is not needed, then greases are used. They act as a lubricant as well as a seal against dirt. Greases used in applications where there are no enclosures to retain a liquid lubricants. Also, they used where parts are inaccessible or leakage of oil is objectionable. They recommended only for a low speed applications as they cannot flow easily and cannot carry away heat generated at high speeds. Next type of the solid lubricants are solid lubricants. The solid materials that exhibits very low friction while sliding are used as a solid lubricants. Example of the solid lubricants are graphite, molybdenum disulfide, that is MOS, etc. Conditions under which solid lubricants are used. They used at extremely high temperatures at which neither lubricating oils nor greases have thermal or oxidation stability. They used in extremely high pressures conditions where contamination by ordinary lubricants must be avoided, or they used as a lubrication of a contacting surface that must conduct electricity. Applications of solid lubricants are Solid lubricants are used in a die casting, chain extrusion, metal cutting, wire drawing, and heavily loaded bearings and gears. Now, selection of a lubricants. Solid lubricant, greases, high viscosity oils, low viscosity oils, and gas lubricants. So, when there is an increasing speed, maximum speed is there, then you can use gas lubricant as compared to the solid lubricants. While increasing load is there, then you can use solid lubricant as compared to the gas lubricant. Factors influencing selection of a lubricants. First factor is speed. Higher speed results in a high frictional heat. Hence, in such cases, in order to reduce the viscous resistance and frictional heat, low viscosity lubricants are preferred. Next factor is load. If the load is high, low viscosity lubricant may get squeezed out, and hence in such cases high viscosity lubricants are preferred. Next factor is temperature. At low temperature, plain mineral oils or greases are preferred, and at extremely high or extremely low temperatures, mineral oils with additives, synthetic oils or solid lubricants are preferred. Next factor for selection of a lubricant which influence the selection of lubricants is geometry. Sometimes geometry restricts the choice of a lubricant. For example, many times an unsealed rolling contact bearing may have to be grease lubricated because there is no space to provide gas lubricants or liquid lubricant. Bearing materials. Before going to bearing materials, we will see which are the desirable properties of the bearing materials. First property is the compressive strength. The bearing material should have high compressive strength to withstand maximum pressure. Second property, fatigue strength. The bearing material should have sufficient endurance strength to avoid the fatigue failure. Third property, conformability. Conformability is the ability of the bearing material to yield and adopt its shape to that of the journal. When the load is applied, the journal deflects, resulting in a contact at the edges. A conformable material adjusts its shape under these circumstances to accommodate the journal without causing the excessive wear. So, conformability property is important. Next property is embeddability. Embeddability is the ability of the bearing material to accommodate or embed small particles of dust or abrasive particles without scoring or wearing the journal. Next property is bondability. Bondability is the ability of bearing material to form strong bond with other materials, especially steel. Many high capacity bearings are made by bonding thin layer of a bearing material to high strength steel shell. An important consideration in selecting the bearing material for such as a construction. Next property or next factor is the corrosion resistance. In applications like engine bearings, the excessive temperature causes oxidation of lubricating oils and form corrosive acids. Hence, the bearing material should have sufficient resistance against corrosion due to attack. Next important factor is the structure. Bearing material should have sufficient duplex structure with hard particles supported in a soft matrix. Next factor is thermal conductivity. The bearing material should have high thermal conductivity so as to permit the rapid dissipation of the heat. Next factor is thermal expansion. The bearing material should have low coefficient of thermal expansion so that when the bearing is operating over a wide range of a temperature, there is a no undue change in a clearance between the journal and bearing. Next factor is cost and availability, which is the most important factor. The bearing material should have reasonable cost and should be easily available in the market. Materials for bearings. Generally, following materials are used for bearings: bronze, copper lead alloy, aluminum alloy, silver, cast iron, sinter metals. Thank you for listening.